Soprano singer Pumeza Matshikiza has graced the biggest stages around the world and is currently back home to perform with the Cape Town Philharmonic Orchestra at Kirstenbosch Gardens on the 22nd of March. That's going to be so beautiful. Take a look at this. Anything like me, that your body is covered in goosebumps right now from that sheer beauty, the quality of voice. Now connect with us online if you've got any questions for Pumeza. Please tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express, or go visit our Facebook page, or comment on a beautiful picture on our Instagram. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, thank you.
Let me just tell you, you are a doll. You are just such a vision to look at, and then even better to sound, to listen to.
Thank you.
Wow, what talent you have.
Thank you.
When was it that you were introduced to opera music? Because it's nothing that I can imagine that a child would, like, resonate with. Or no, did it happen for you?
No, it didn't happen as a child. I mean, I grew up singing in choirs.
Yeah.
In South Africa, we have this amazing, amazing tradition of choral music.
Yeah.
And I discovered opera when I was about 14 or 15 years old, yeah, on the radio, and I just fell in love with it. I think because also I was already singing in choirs,
yeah,
and so it was kind of an extra layer or an extra level of what we were doing in choirs, but I was so amazed and I really wanted to be able to sing like that, because wow, I could tell that there was a lot of work that, yeah, went through being able to sing like that, so I was fascinated by it.
Your talent has taken you all over the world to perform on some of the most incredible stages. You opened up for the Commonwealth Games.
I did.
In front of 40,000 people. Were you discovered? Like, did somebody hear you and say, wow, this, we're taking this girl to the world? Or did you have an agent? Like, how did you break into opera?
Actually, I left for London to do my, yeah, postgrad at the Royal College of Music in 2004. I was lucky to meet a composer called Kevin Volans, and I did some work with him, and he was very much interested in sponsoring me to go to the UK to do an audition.
Yeah.
And when I did the audition, he bought me the flight ticket. When I did the audition, I got a full scholarship, so I studied in London for 3 years, freelanced. So, and then I got a recording deal with Decca Classics, which, yeah, is a really one of the most reputable labels for classical music. So it started happening like that. There was one thing after another happening.
Yeah.
Scholarship, Royal Opera House, Young Artist Program, this Decca contract. So
incredible.
Just, yeah.
And how competitive is the industry? Like, is it really difficult to, like, scale up?
The industry is really competitive, yeah, especially sopranos.
Okay.
There are many sopranos in the world. I don't know. There are just so many sopranos in the world. The tenors,
yeah,
the tenors have it much easier, because, yeah, you could be not such a great tenor, but you could still, you know, have a career and make things work. But for sopranos, yes, yeah, it is highly competitive.
You live in Berlin now.
I live in Berlin.
Berlin, for me, is such a sexy city. It's really, really great. What's life like there for you?
Oh, Berlin is amazing. Actually, for me, Berlin is nothing like the rest of Germany.
No, not at all.
It's like a country on its own.
Cape Town to South Africa is Berlin to Germany and New York to America.
Exactly.
It's their own place.
Exactly, exactly like that. Even my friends who are German, when they come to Berlin, they're like, oh, it doesn't feel like Germany at all.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's amazing, very arty, you know, very free. I find that it doesn't have such a structured identity, although the main language is German, of course, but everyone is there and everything is, and people in Berlin are very much interested in seeing new things.
Yeah.
If you want to if you want to do a show where you just get naked and talk about whatever.
I've been to that
club. You will have people coming to just see that, you know, the craziest thing.
Yeah,
you
people, want they're super open-minded.
They're so open-minded. They want to see what you are about. What's this art? They give everything a chance.
So do you, what I is find your life like? Do you gig a lot? Do you have, like, regular performances?
Well,
there?
I have... I'm a freelancer, so I'm not attached to one opera house. I do concerts, and I also do opera in different opera houses. When I've done lots of opera, I prefer concerts, because concerts, they take you around the world much lesser than... you have less time doing concerts than operas. When you do an opera, you stay maybe... For example, I did an opera where I was away for 5 months doing two operas, one opera and then another one. So I was like, no, now I want to do concerts. So sometimes I prefer concerts, and sometimes I miss doing recitals where you just sing classical songs with a piano, or concerts with an orchestra, or an opera with a full orchestra.
Amazing. Now, opera is often sung in Italian. Are you fluent in Italian now? Or?
My Italian is good enough, I would say. My German is better.
Really?
Yeah, I speak more German.
But now, those aren't your only talents, because I heard that you know what to do with these.
Oh, my God!
And it's not eating. Do you want to give us a little show?
No, I'm going to be too nervous.
No, you can do it.
Yeah,
girl. You're
a genius. Come on. I was wondering what you were going to do with this apple.
You're so beautiful. I love you. You see, we're just celebrating women and their beauty and their talent all damn day. Thank you for doing that.
I needed six.
Can you juggle six?
No, it's a joke.
So now we've asked you if you've got any amazing questions for Pumeza. And Namon Dendlo asked, hashtag Afternoon Express, what are the challenges of being a soprano singer? Like in the industry, I suppose, what are the main challenges? Do you lose your voice a lot?
Yes, I do use my voice quite a lot. Yeah. You need time to rest,
but
also as you get older, your voice changes. So when how you sang when you're 25, it gets heavier, you start to develop certain mannerisms, which you need to clean. You know, it's being an opera singer is more like being a sports person.
Yeah.
You train your voice, you try to keep healthy. I mean, I don't do any extra rituals, but I try to keep healthy.
You do boxing, though, that keeps you super healthy.
I did boxing for some time, and then I stopped. Now I have a new ritual. It's called the Five Tibetans. They
are
amazing.
Tibetans,
the Five Tibetans exercises, they're about five exercises.
Yeah.
And you do up to 21 repetitions. You start from 3 up to 21. And
it's like yoga Pilates based?
Yeah. It's something like that. And you can do it for 10, 15 minutes. Okay. You know, even when you're lazy, you can do it. And it's very old. They're quite old, about 2,500 years old.
I'm Googling that, the Five Tibetans. Google it as well at home and let us know if you start. The Five Tibetans.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to try it. Our next question is from Shireen Abrahams. And she's asked, hi, Pumeza. At what age did you discover your love to be a soprano singer?
Well, I started singing when I was 5 years old, but it was not opera, of course.
Yeah.
I sang in church with my mother and my brother, and I also sang in school choirs.
Yeah, with the soprano came?
I was already singing kind of soprano, but child soprano, child soprano parts. I started training professionally when I was 21.
Okay, beautiful. You are just amazing. And of course, Pumeza will be back with us a little bit later in the show for an exclusive performance that you do not want to miss. Shucks, I can't do that. After the break, though, we cross to Pumeza, who is currently in the beachside town of Komaki with lifestyle blogger Babalwa Ndwalana. I've got to remember how to say that. And of course, she recently got engaged, so we're going to be chatting to her after the break.